In ArcGIS Pro, you can add dynamic tables to your layouts. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to add a table frame and modify its appearance. The map I have here was created using a layer from the Living Atlas. As you can see in the legend, I've symbolized it by regions in the United States. This is a layer I'm going to use to create the table frame. When a table frame is added to the layout, it adds the first 10 fields from the attribute table. For this tutorial, I only want to show a few, so let's turn off some of these. The term dynamic table means that any time the extent of the map frame is changed, the data in the table frame will update to only show data within that extent. The fitting strategy also automatically adjusts the table's columns and maximizes the font size within the limits of the table frame. To list the contents in the table frame by state, I'm going to add a new sort field. This will display the states in alphabetical order. Now let's modify the appearance of the table frame itself. I'm going to change the background of the heading to separate it from the rest of the table. And to make the data in the rows of the table more readable, let's modify the backgrounds. This gives us a nice alternating effect. The numerical values in the population field are quite long, so let's go into the table itself and add a 1000 separator to this field. I'm also going to right align these numbers to give us a little more space between the fields. Dynamic tables also work with map series. I'm going to create a spatial map series and use the state name as a sort field to create a page for each state. As I click through each page, the map frame and table frame will automatically update.